गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हेलो, वेलकम बैक टू अवर ई लर्निंग प्रोग्राम इनिशिएटेड बाय विद्याधीश विद्या संकुल अंडर द गाइडलाइंस ऑफ डॉक्टर जी एम सुतरिया सर. ओके, एंड सी, इन अवर लास्ट लेक्चर वी कंप्लीट अप टू इलस्ट्रेशन नंबर 6 एज वेल एज एक्सरसाइज 5.1 योर डाउट, दैट इज 2-3 सम्स ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 5.1 एंड ऑल द differentiation by definition. Okay, so here we complete our method number 1, and in our last lecture we show that two important formula, that is method number 2 for the differentiation. Right, now see, there are in page number 173 there are again 14 formulas, 14 rules, right, 4 rules for the next sums, but we will see that into the sum, whenever that some particular sum are there into the illustration is come, then at that time we show that particular rule. At means we, I want to say that here method wise we will go through this chapter. Here only second method, that is y is equal to x raised to n, and we want dy by dx, that is n into x raised to n by 1, and y is equal to constant k, dy by dx is equal to 0. That is our method number 2, and we will concentrate on this, and we will start the sum, that is illustration number 7 from that particular method. Okay, so read the question. See, it is always into this, from this chapter. See, yes, I forget to give you a blueprint from this chapter. See here, section A, one question, and it is 10th, 1 mark. Here I am giving you a blueprint. I forgot to give you a blueprint of this chapter, so that's why I am giving you here this blueprint, section A. In section A, one question, 1 mark will ask, and that is your 10th question. Now section B, one question again, that is your 20th question, and it is again for 1 mark, right? Now in section C, two questions, question number 29 and 30. Two marks each. So total 4 marks. And section D, one mark, 4 mark, and section D, 1 question from section D, directly from section E, 1 question of 4 marks. section A, one question, one mark. Section B, one question, one mark. Section C, two questions, total 4 marks. Direct section E, one question, 4 marks. Here 2 into 2 and here 4 into 1. 1 into 1 and 1 into 1. Right? So total 10 marks. So this chapter will ask in 10 marks. So here one MCQ is there, one SQ is there, 2 marks, 2 questions, that is short sums. See here, question number 7, illustration number 7, 1, 2, 6 and 7, 8, 9, 10, all are the short sums. That's why here it will ask in 2 marks and 2 marks, 2 sums. And in one sum, alternative is also given. So total 3 questions here in section C, total 3 questions will ask, and you have to write from these 3, you have to write 2 questions, right? So 2 questions for 2 marks, that is 4 marks. And the last one, section E, one question for 4 mark, will ask here. And that's why total 4 plus 4 plus 1 plus 1, total 10 marks chapter is there. And it is also an important one because, see, after the practice, see, limit is very easy for you. So again, after the practice, this chapter, that is chapter number 5, differentiation is also easy to you. And you will get 10 out of 10 from this chapter as limit. Okay. So here, this is your blueprint. First of all, write down this blueprint into your fair book. And here, then we'll start our illustration number 7. Okay. So first of all, write down this blueprint. Now, see the question. Illustration number 7. Find dy by dx for y is equal to x raised to 4 3 minus 3x square plus 2x minus 3. Right? So we have to find out the dy by dx, that is differentiation from this. So I am removing here that blueprint. Illustration number 7. Y is equal to x raised to 4 minus 3x cube plus 2x minus 3. Not cube here, it is square. X raised to 4 minus 3x square plus 2x minus 3. And we have to find out a dy by dx. Okay. So here your dy by dx we have to find out, and your y is equal to this is given. So first of all, we have to write down that if dy by dx is equal to d by dx of y. What is your y? You have to write that y here. See, dy by dx is equal to d by dx of what? Of y. Here, y means what? Y means this. We have to write d by dx of the question x cube x raised to 4 minus 3x square plus 2x minus 3. Okay. So now we have to separate all the variables, that is d by dx of x raised to 4 minus sign is here. Now d by dx of, see here, if 3, first of all we have to write just 3x square, then minus, sorry, plus d by dx of 2x, then minus d by dx of 3. See, this is the step and you have to compulsory write this step, because here it is just 2 marks sum, and here if we find out the answer, then it is from one line or one step you can get the answer as per the formula. But we want 2 marks for that, so we have to write all the steps. See, these are all are the extra steps, but we have to write that particular steps. Whenever the sum, in the sum, they will ask that y is equal to so and so, and we have to find out just dy by dx, then at that time we have to write down these steps, 4 to 5 steps. Otherwise we can directly say the answer here from the question. We can directly say the answer, what is the answer, in only one step. But to find out, to get 2 marks from these sum, we have to write down all the steps. Okay, so please concentrate here, which are the extra step we have to write to get the 2 marks full. See here, here there is no any multiplication, so we just have to write as it is d by dx x raised to 4, nothing else, right? But here, see that 3 are the multiple of x square. We want to find out d by dx, that is differentiation with respect to x. What means of d by dx? D by dx means what? Here we are finding out that particular variable differentiation with respect to x, right? So here we want the differentiation of x, not 3. 3 is the multiple of that particular variable. So first of all we have to separate that, because we want to find out the x, differentiation of x, not 3, right? 3 is the multiplier of x square, and we have to just separate that, and for that we have to write here 3 into d by dx into x square. I am just separating the 3x square. Here whatever the multiplier is given here we have to just separate and write down in the first, then d by dx and then x square. We have to write like this. This is your next step. Here plus, again 2 is here, so we have to separate that also. So 2 into d by dx into x, and here no x is given, so we have to write as it is, no change, that is d by dx into bracket 3, right? So after this is the step. So first of all you have to write d by dx and then full y, then we have to separate particular full observations, right? Full variable we have to write d by dx x raised to 4 minus d by dx 3x square plus d by dx 2x minus d by dx 3. Then we have to separate the multiplier of x square, right? And we have to use the formula right now. What is the formula? See here, if y is equal to x raised to n, then dy by dx is equal to n into x raised to n minus 1 is the formula. See the formula, if y is equal to x raised to n, then dy by dx is equal to n into x raised to n minus 1, right? So here what is the simplification as per the formula for this? See, d by dx of x raised to 4 is your n, that's why here answer is 4 into x raised to 4 minus 1. 4, that is your n, into x raised to 4 minus 1. Here the x raised to 4 differentiation is 4x raised to 4 minus 1 minus 3 as it is, into bracket differentiation of x square 2 is your n, that's why 2 into x raised to 2 minus 1 is the differentiation of x square, right? And 3 is the multiplier, plus 2 into x. What is the differentiation of x? See here, whenever no power is given, we have to assume, or we can say it is one power. Whenever the power is not given, here x square, x raised to 4, 4 is power, 2 is power here, but here into on the x, this x, no power is given, then we can say it is x raised to 1. And what is the differentiation of these? 1 into x raised to 1 minus 1, x raised to n, x raised to 1. 1 into x raised to 1 minus 1. Got this? So here we can write 1 into x raised to 1 minus 1. That is the differentiation. And minus, see here, here no x is there. So we can say it is a constant. Y is equal to constant k. Then dy by dx is equal to what? 0. This is our method number 1. In method number 1, I told you that first formula is y is equal to x raised to n. And the second formula is y is equal to constant. When x raised to n dy by dx is equal to n into x raised to n minus 1. And when constant is given, dy by dx is equal to 0. Right? So here, constant is here, no x is there. That's why we can say the differentiation of 3, 5, 15, whatever amount is given, that is constant amount. That is, x is not multiplied with the particular amount. At that time, it is a constant amount. And we have to write directly dy by dx is equal to 0. So here we can say the differentiation is 0. Right? Okay. Now, see here. What is the simplification of this? 4x cube 4 into x raised to 4 minus 1, that is cube, minus 3 into 2, that is 6. 3 into 2, 6 into x raised to 1. And we don't have to write, because see here, x raised to 1 is not written at anywhere. Right? 2x means what? X raised to 1. Here, 6x means what? X raised to 1. Whenever x raised to 1 is there, we don't have to write x raised to 1. If power is 2 or more than 2, then we have to write. Means what? If here power is more than 2, that is 3. Here the power is more less than 2, that is 1. We don't have to write. We just have to write x. Right? Okay. Now plus 2. 2 ones are 2. X raised to 0, I already told you in the limit chapter that whenever any amount raised to 0 is equal to 1, 5 raised to 0 is equal to 1, 10 raised to 0 is equal to 1, x raised to 0 again is equal to 1. Here x raised to 1 minus 1, that is what? 0. 0 means what? 1. X raised to 0 is equal to 1, that is 2 into 1 into 1, that is 2. 2 into 1 into 1, x raised to 0 is equal to 1. That's why 2, total multiplication is 2, 1s are 2, 1s are 2. Right? So answer is 2. Minus 0. See here, minus 0 is there. So you don't have to write these, because whenever minus 0 or plus 0 is there, we don't have to write this. Right? So it is no matter we have to write or not. We don't have to write whenever minus or plus 0 is there in the last. Okay, so this is your answer. See, your final answer, that means you can say the differentiation is here x raised to 4 minus 3x square plus 2x minus 3, y is equal to, it is given, and your final answer, that is differentiation of these. See, this is 2 mark sum. So here we can directly say that from this formula, x raised to n is equal to n into x raised to n minus 1. We can directly say that, see here, x raised to 4 means 4x cube directly. See here, 4x raised to 4, that is n into x raised to n minus 1. What is the direct answer of this? 4x cube minus 3 2s are, see, we have to multiply power with the multiplier. So here 3 2s are 6x raised to 1, that is 6x only, plus 2. 1 power is there, 2 1s are 2, and here power is 0, 1 minus 1, that is 0. So direct we have to write 2 only, right? So from this we can say that, see here, please, if you don't understand, please write down this. I am removing here that, and one extra formula for that, see here, it is not given into the textbook, but I am writing that formula. If y is equal to x, then dy by dx is equal to 1. Write down this formula in method number 2. Method number 2, one formula, y is equal to x raised to n. Method number 2, formula number 2, y is equal to k constant. And in method number 2, y is equal to x is given, then dy by dx is equal to directly 1. So here 2x is given. So here x differentiation is 1. 2 into 1, that is 2, is your answer. From the question, directly you can write the answer. See here, 4x cube minus 3 2s are 6x, only 1 power is here. And here 2 1s are 2, because x differentiation is 1. So 2 1s are 2 plus 2 minus 0, we don't have to write that 0. Constant we don't have to write, so ignore the constant here. Whatever the x are there, we have to write that particular answer of x. Here is your answer, but here it is 2 mark sum, so we have to write stepwise these and these. 3 steps we have to compulsory write. Okay, so please concentrate. This is somehow it is difficult, because it is not your commerce chapter, it is your science chapter. But now in new course after 2017, it is in your 12th commerce standard syllabus. Okay, so please write down this. This is your illustration number 7. And if you don't understand any of these, then please see again and again this video. Okay, so I am in detail explain you all these things, but if you miss anything, then please see this video again and again, and you can understand this. Okay, so this is your illustration number 7. I am complete here that, and now we will start our next illustration, that is illustration number 8. Okay, so what is your illustration number 8? Find dy by dx for y is equal to x cube plus root x minus 4 by x plus x upon root cube root of x plus 1 by 4. See the difficulties. Style of the questions here change. And here the style is changed, not in the other form, but the mathematics is there. Mathematics rules is apply here. In chapter number 4, again I told you, in chapter number 4, in the limit chapter, mathematics are there, mathematics rule will apply here. And in chapter number 5, again mathematics rule, all the rules of 1 to 10 standard mathematics, that is basic mathematics rules, is apply. We have to first simplify the question, and then we can get the answer, right? So here the question style is twisted. First of all, we have to simplify the question, and then we can get the our regular answer. So I am writing that, see here, dy by dx. What is the dy by dx? If for y is equal to x cube plus root x minus 4 by x plus 1 upon root cube, cube root x plus 1 upon 4. See, last 1 upon 4 is your constant. So, we have to ignore that particular constant, right? And in the first 3, we have to first simplify that and then we can get the answer. Okay, so I am writing here that particular y is equal to x cube plus root x minus 4 by x plus 1 upon cube root x plus 1 by 4. See, what is the simplification of this? Whenever x is given into the denominator, we have to convert that into first numerator and then we can find out the differentiation. See, the question, whenever in the question, the x is given into the denominator. What means of that? See here, x is in the numerator, here again x in the numerator, then here x is given in the denominator. So we have to, here we have to convert that into the numerator. Again here x is in the denominator, we have to convert that into the numerator, and here constant is given. So in the constant we don't have to change anything, okay? But whenever the x is given in the denominator, we have to change it, right? So see here, what is the answer, what is the simplification of this? Y is equal to, not dy by dx, here we not find out, we are not finding out the dy by dx first, we are just simplify this question, right? So here x cube as it is, no change, plus x raised to x cube means what, sorry, x square root of x means what? I told you in my last lecture, whenever the square root is given, here we have to write x raised to 1 by 2. Cube root is given, we have to write x raised to 1 by 3. Fourth root is given, we have to write x raised to 1 by 4. Whatever the root is given, we have to write like this. So if you don't know this, then first of all, write down this also into your example book. This is the simplification of root x, root cube x, root fourth root as x, right? So here I have to write that x raised to 1 by 2, right, minus 4 into, see, I want to convert the denominator into the numerator. For that, what we have to do, we have to write x raised to minus 1. See, here x raised to what? 1. If power is not given, I told you in my last example that when power is not given, it means x raised to 1. Here it is given in the denominator. But whenever we are converting that into the numerator, we have to write minus sign. That is minus 1. Power is 1, but we have, whatever, whenever we are converting that into the numerator, we have to write minus 1 is the power of x. Again here plus 1 into x raised to, here again we are converting that. What is the answer of cube root x? Here cube root x is equal to x raised to 1 by 3, but it is in the denominator. Whenever we are converting denominator into the numerator, we have to write down a minus sign. That means here we have to write minus 1 by 3. See, here 1 is there. So here we are writing x raised to minus 1. Here x cube root, that is x raised to 1 by 3. But it is in the denominator, we have to write minus 1 by 3. Minus sign we have to write whenever we are converting from denominator to numerator. Right? Okay. plus 1 by 4 as it is constant, we don't have to see the constant. Whatever constant is given, we don't have to simplify that, because the answer of that particular constant is always 0, right? So here I am just simplify this. So now direct dy by dx is equal to d by dx of x cube plus x raised to 1 by 2 minus 4 into x raised to minus 1 plus 1 we don't write, x raised to minus 1 by 3, 1 into whatever the amount is there, so we don't write 1 here, plus 1 by 4, right? This is now your question. We are just simplify the question. Now separate this, all the observations here, d by dx x cube plus d by dx x raised to 1 by 2 minus 4. We have to separate 4 directly here. Okay, we directly separate the 4 here. 4 into d by dx x raised to minus 1 plus d by dx x raised to minus 1 by 3. See, you have to write minus compulsory. And last plus d by dx is equal to x raised to 1 by 4. Right? So here just we separate all the variables. Now what is the answer of this? 3 into x raised to 3 minus 1 plus 1 by 2 into x raised to 1 by 2 minus 1 minus 4 into minus 1 into x raised to minus 1 minus 1. See here, minus 1. What is the formula? When y is equal to x raised to n, dy by dx is equal to n into x raised to n minus 1. See, 4 is the multiplier, so we have write 4. Now the differentiation of these, minus 1, that is your n, into x raised to n minus 1. N is minus 1, minus 1 for the, as per the formula. Here n minus 1, n is minus 1, minus 1, right? So here simplification of this, that is differentiation of x raised to minus 1, is minus 1 into x raised to minus 1 minus 1. Again here plus x raised to, sorry, not x raised to, first of all we have to write down the n here, n, that's why minus 1 by 3 x raised to minus 1 by 3 minus 1, minus 1 by 3 minus 1, right? And plus here, what is the differentiation of constant? Here not x, directly 1 by 4, right? So what is the differentiation of constant? That is 0, right? So here see the simplification of this. Okay, so try by yourself first of all. See here, I am giving you here 2 minutes to simplify this or to understand this step. See here, the step, second step, I am giving you here 2 minutes to understand these and these step. Two steps are difficult. First of all, you have to see that how can we find out this step. First we just separate the all the illustration, all the observations, and then we just differentiate all the observations. So first of all, please see that first 2 step and do your next step by yourself. I am giving you here 2 to 3 minutes. Okay. ओके, आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड दीज टू स्टेप्स. नाउ वील कंटिन्यू विथ अवर नेक्स्ट स्टेप. आई होप यू डिड दैट. नाउ वॉट इज द सिंप्लीफिकेशन ऑफ दिस. सी हियर, 3x square, 3 into x raised to 3 minus 1, that is 3x square plus 1 by 2 into x raised to, see what is the simplification of these, 1 by 2 minus 1, what is that? We have to take LCM, 1 minus 2 divided by 2, 2 ones are 2, that's why 2, 1 minus 2 divided by 2. So here, what is the simplification of this? That is minus 1 by 2. So here, power simplification is, here 1 by 2 x raised to minus 1 by 2 minus 4 ones are 4 minus minus plus 4. 4 ones are 4. See here, I multiply these two, minus 4, minus 1, 4 ones are 4, right? And here, what is the multiplication of these? Into x raised to minus 1 means what? Minus, minus, plus. But sign is minus. So here, minus 2, right? 4 into x raised to minus 2, plus. See here, plus, minus. Now we are multiplying these two. Plus and minus. So plus minus minus 1 by 3 as it is. X raised to what? We have to simplify this also. Minus 1 by 3 into minus 1. What is the simplification? See here. Minus 1 by 3 minus 1. Means here 3 ones are 3. But minus 1 minus 3. Divided by 3. We have to take the LCM of this. That's why. What is the answer here? Minus 4 by 3. See, minus 1, minus 1 by 3, minus 1. That is, what is the simplification of this? Minus 4 by 3. See here, we have to write minus 4 by 3 as your power of x. And in the last, the answer is 0, or we can, I told you that we don't have to write that 0 also. Here your answer is complete. But here, if the question is given into this format, we have to convert. See, into this, no minus sign or power is given, right? And in our answer, here in the power minus 1 by 2, here again in the power minus 2, here again in the power minus 4 by 3 is right, is here, right? So we have to convert. See, whenever into the question we are converting denominator into the numerator, then again in the answer we have to convert numerator into denominator if the power is negative. Here the power is negative, here again the power is negative, here again the power is negative. So we have to convert the numerator into the denominator, and we are writing the positive sign. We have to write the positive sign. So what is the simplification? See, this is your answer, but we have to simplify, or we have to convert that minus power into plus, right? So here, what is the answer? See that 3x square as it is, no change, plus 1 upon 2. See here, if power is in negative, we have to convert it into the denominator, from numerator to denominator, and that minus will convert into the plus. So here, x raised to 1 by 2. 1 upon 2, x into x raised to minus 1 by 2. Here we are writing in the denominator, that's why minus 1 by 2 become a plus 1 by 2. That is, your answer is 1 upon 2 x raised to 1 by 2. Now plus 4 x raised to 2 minus 2 is in the numerator. Whenever we are converting the numerator into the numerator, we have to write positive sign, that is here x square 4 upon x square. This is the simplification of this. Minus sign, powers minus sign we have to convert into plus, and we have to write down the numerator into the denominator. And the last one, minus 1 upon 3 x raised to 4 by 3. Here minus 4 by 3, that's why we are converting 4 by 3 into plus, and that's we are writing into the denominator, that is 3, 1 upon 3 into x raised to 4 by 3. This is your final answer. If you are writing this as your final answer, then you cannot get a full marks. Half marks will cut for this step. Please write down all the step, and if you don't understand any step, then see here, I am explaining you this sum again. Illustration number 8. Okay, so here y is equal to x cube plus root x minus 4 upon x plus 1 upon root cube root x plus 1 upon 4. First of all, we have to simplify this. So what is the simplification of this? See, I am separate all the steps. If it is congested, see the steps. Right, so I am separate all the steps here. I think so it's look like good now. Y is equal to x cube plus x raised to 1 by 2 minus 4 into x raised to minus 1 plus 1 into x raised to minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4. Here x is we are converting root x into x raised to, see root x is equal to x raised to 1 by 2, right, minus 4 into x raised to minus 1. Whenever the x is given into the denominator, we have to convert that into the numerator, and we have to write the minus sign. Okay, here 1 by 3 root x, cube root x, that is again 1 into x raised to minus 1 by 3. Again it is in the denominator, we have to write into the numerator minus sign. Cube root x is equal to x raised to 1 by 3. And here x raised to minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4. Now differentiation, we want differentiation. We just simplify this here into the second step. Now we have to take the differentiation, that is dy by dx is equal to d by dx into this. Full. Nothing else. Right? And now separate all the observations, all the variables, d by dx x cube, d by dx x raised to 1 by 2, 4 into d by dx x raised to minus 1, d by dx x raised to minus 1 by 3, and d by dx 1 by 4, right? And here, see, we are differentiate as per the formula y is equal to x raised to n, that's why dy by dx is equal to n into x raised to n minus 1. So here, 3 into x raised to 3 minus 1, then 1 by 2 into x raised to 1 by 2 minus 1, then 4 ones are, see, 4 is as it is a multiplier, so minus 4 as it is, minus 1 into x raised to minus 1 minus 1, why, here n is minus 1, n into the formula minus 1 is there, so minus 1 is for n, and here for formula minus 1, that's why minus 1 minus 1, again, plus minus 1 by 3, x raised to minus 1 by 3, that is your n minus 1, and plus constant differentiation is 0. Okay, so here what is the simplification of this? 3x square plus 1 by 2 x raised to, see I am simplify this, please see that 1 by 2 minus 1, that is 1 2 za 1, that is 1 minus 2 by 2, that is minus 1 by 2 is the sign. 4 x raised to minus 4 plus minus 4 plus into minus 1 minus minus plus, then 4 into x raised to minus 1 minus 1, that is minus 2, plus minus minus 1 by 3 x raised to, see here I am simplify also this here, minus 1 by 3 minus 1, that is 3 1s are 3, minus 1 minus 3 minus 4 by 3. Okay, this is your answer, but you have to simplify this because the question, into the question no minus power is given. So here minus power is there, so we have to convert that minus power into positive, and for that we have to take all the minus power into positive, and we have to take that into, convert that into from numerator to denominator. So 3x square as it is, 1 by 2 into x is in the numerator, now x in the denominator, x raised to 1 by 2, power no change in the power, just change the position from numerator to denominator to change the sign. Here plus 4 again raised to 2, that is x raised to 2, minus minus from convert to plus minus 1 by 3 x raised to minus 4 by 3, here x raised to 4 by 3, right? So here illustration number 8 is over, and see, time for homework. There is no 5.1, 5.2, 5.3, any exercise is there. Directly exercise number 5 is there. So, it is easy to you. See, today just we do the two sums, and for that you have to find out. See, I am giving the homework. Here there is no simple questions like these, illustration number 7 and 8 into the exercise. So today there is a no homework. You are free from the homework in this lecture. Here you have to just see, you have to just write down these sums into your exercise book, example book, and as well as you have to practice these two sums. See, your homework is practice your illustration number 7 and 8 in rough book two times. Okay, so this is just your homework. Okay, here I am complete my lecture. So thank you, class.